Hello, I'm Rebecca Korth, and thank you for taking the time to enjoy my piece in Birds and Art. Having grown up in Marshfield, Wisconsin, I've known about this exhibit all my life, and I'm so excited to be a part of it. After graduating from UW-Madison, go Badgers, I left Wisconsin for a few years to study with my aunt, another professional artist, in Portland, Oregon. I learned the technical aspects of oil painting, but my aunt couldn't help me with my muse. I painted landscapes, florals, animals, and the occasional still life, but nothing felt inspired. I returned to Marshfield when my mother became ill. She had a rare lung condition which kept her in bed for most of the day. My father filled her view of the backyard with thousands of flowers, small waterfalls, and most importantly, bird feeders. I can't help but smile, recalling the many hours we spent together, watching the birds at play. After she passed, I began painting still lifes almost exclusively, and I found myself adding a bird to every painting. Mom, I had my muse. For the piece in front of you, bluebirds, bartlets, and caracaras, the composition began in my newly remodeled kitchen, after I noticed how wonderful the quartz countertop reflected light. I had this cut crystal bowl of fruit sitting out, and the multicolor shadow it cast was simply stunning, so I knew I had to paint it. I grabbed an unused porcelain tile from the remodel, my fruit and bowl, and ran to my studio. However, before I could even begin sketching, I realized I needed something else to balance the piece. My Chinese vase was perfect, both for its added height and for the color palette. Lastly, I needed to pick a bird. The eastern bluebird with its gorgeous orange and blue plumage was the obvious choice. I then painted the bird as though it was perched in my still life, mimicking the light hitting it at the exact same angle. This piece took much longer than usual, as it was my first attempt at painting items larger than they appear in real life. With the ability to show more detail, deciding what to paint and what to leave out was a constant struggle for me. Fast forward a little over a month, and the piece was finally finished. The once vibrant, juicy fruit, however, had definitely seen better days. In the end, I love how it turned out, and I hope you do too.